हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वील कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर 9, दैट इज हेरिडिटी एंड एवोल्यूशन। लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मेंडल्स मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस, मीन्स वेयर ही हैज टेकन ओनली वन ट्रीट। टुडे वील बी टॉकिंग अबाउट वेयर द मेंडल टुक टू ट्रेट्स, टू विजिबल कंट्रास्टिंग करेक्टर्स। ट्रेट मीन्स करेक्टर्स। ही वॉन्टेड टू नो वेदर द इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ टू ट्रेट्स दे आर इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ ईच अदर और देर इज सम कनेक्शन वेन द टू करेक्टर्स आर टेकन टूगेदर फॉर द इनहेरिटेंस। दिस लॉ इज नोन एज अ डाई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस। डाई हाइब्रिड मीन्स वेन मेंडल टुक टू करेक्टर्स। Now, Mendel selected two characters of the garden pea, that is a Pisum sativum, and we have already discussed the seven characters on which the Mendel work. You can take any two characters in one parent for the dihybrid cross, but I will stick to those two characters which are given in the textbook. That means the Mendel took the two characters. One is the color of the seeds, either the seeds were green in color or they were yellow in color, and the shape of the seed, either the seeds were round in shape or they were wrinkled. And Mendel selected these two traits in the parental generation. So the parental generation, as I told you, the parental generation must be a homozygous for the two traits. That means it should be a pure line trait. Now, when Mendel crossed two plants, then in the F1 generation, all the plants show only one character, that is a yellow color seeds and the round shaped. What does it mean? It means that these two characters, that is yellow color of the seed and the round shape of the seeds, these are the dominant character. Why? Because in F1 generation only one trait will appear, and that trait which appear in the F1 generation, that is always dominant. So in the seed color, the yellow color, that is dominant, and the round shape is dominant. Now Mendel wanted to see what happened in the F2 generation. For F2 generation, as we discussed earlier, you don't have to take the parent generation, but you have to take the two plants from the F1 generation. So he took two plants for F1 generation, or he allowed the self-pollination or self-fertilization of a plant. In parental generation, only the cross fertilization takes place. In rest of the generation, that is in F2 or F3 or F4 generation, only the self pollination that has been done. Now, in the F2 generation, Mendel found that four different combination of the plants were there. What were those? Some of the plants, they were of yellow color and round seeds. And this yellow color and the round seed, these two characters were not present in one parent. He found some of the seeds, they were yellow colored, but they were wrinkled. This is also, these two traits are also not present in one of the parent. Whereas the third combination which he observed was some of the seeds, they were yellow color and with the wrinkled seed. These two characters, they were present in one of the parent. And again, the fourth combination which he found was that the seeds were green in color and they were round in shape, and this was also, these two characters, they were also found in the parental generation. So first two characters together, they were not present in any of the parental generation. That means ये दो जो characters हैं वो newly formed characters हैं. कोई भी parent ऐसा नहीं था जो उसमें yellow color seed हो और round shape हो. कोई भी ऐसा पीरियड नहीं था जिसमें ग्रीन कलर के सीड हों और रिंकल्ड हों. दीज टू कम्बिनेशन देवर न्यूली फॉर्म्ड और देवर फाउंड इन द एफ टू जनरेशन. लेट अस डिस्कस दिस डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस इन अ डिटेल. येलो कलर दैट इज डोमिनेंट. हाउ मेंडल कैन से दैट येलो कलर इज डोमिनेंट? बिकॉज ही डिड मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस एंड फाउंड दैट इन F1 जनरेशन ऑल द प्लांट्स वर द ऑल द सीड्स वर ऑफ येलो कलर. सो येलो कलर इज डोमिनेंट. सो इट इज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन कैपिटल वाई. एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट द डोमिनेंट करेक्टर शुड ऑलवेज बी रिटर्न विद द कैपिटल लेटर. एंड द ग्रीन कलर इज अ रिसेसिव करेक्टर विच इज सिम्बोलाइज बाय स्मॉल वाई. सिमिलरली राउंड सीड शेप is a dominant character which is represented by the capital R, whereas the wrinkled seeds, it is a recessive character and which is symbolized by small r. So when he took the parental generation, so P generation means parental generation, and as I told you, parental generation may, you can take any two characters, two dominant characters also or two recessive characters also, but I'll stick to the textbook. He took one parent where the green color seeds were there, which was a recessive character, and round seeds were there. It is a dominant character. So as I told you that for any character two alleles are there. So capital R, that is a for round, which is a dominant character, and small y, it is of recessive green color. Why? Because yellow color is dominant. So in one parent, one of the characters were dominant and the other was recessive. But this was a pure line. Pure line means if these plants were allowed to self-pollinate, they keep on giving the same combination generation after generation. So second plant parent, it was yellow color of the seeds and the shape of the seeds were wrinkled. That means one was the dominant character, yellow color seed, which is a dominant character. That is why it was expressed by capital Y. And the wrinkled seeds, it is a recessive character, so small y. Now he cross-pollinated these two plants. Before the fertilization, gametes formation takes place. So only one type of gametes will be formed here. The gametes will have one capital R and one small y, because gametes will have one allele for a character. In the parent, two genes which are known as the allelic genes, they are present. But gametes ke andar only one allele is there of each character. So since we are taking two characters together, the gametes will have one allele for both the characters. So one R, that is for the round seed, and small y, it is for the green color. Similarly, the second parent plant, it will also produce one type of gametes only, which have capital Y, that is yellow color allele, and the small r, which is the wrinkled seed. So these were the gametes which are produced by the parent. And then in the F1 generation, all the plants, they will have capital R, small y, and capital Y, small y. That means the round color, round seeds and the yellow color, all the F1 generation organisms, they were having round shape of the seed and yellow color of the seeds. That means both dominant character, because as I told you, in F1 generation, all the organism will show the dominant character. Now to produce the F2 generation, he wanted to produce the F2 generation. F2 generation kaise produce karenge? By self-pollinating the F1 organism. So this is an F1 organism. Before fertilization, before self-pollination, the gametes will be formed. Now here, how many type of gametes will be formed? Four type of gametes will be formed. Some of the gametes will have capital R and capital Y. Some of the gametes will have capital R but small y. Some of the gametes will have small r but capital Y. And the fourth type of gametes which are formed, will have small r and small y. So here four different type of male gametes will be formed and four different type of female gametes will be formed. That and after the gamete formation, the fertilization takes place, and the fertilization is random fertilization. To find out the F2 progeny, in one direction, all the male gametes, they are kept, that means on the this horizontal side, all the male gametes are there, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, and small r, small y. These are the male gametes. This symbol is for the male and this symbol is for the female. And on this side, all the four types of female gametes are there. And then the fertilization takes place. That means fertilization is a random fertilization. Any female gamete can fuse with any of the male gamete. Say for example, this female gamete, if it fuses with this male gamete, the resultant progeny will be capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. Or this female gamete can fuse with this male gamete. Or the third possibility is this male gamete can fuse with this female gamete, or this female gamete can fuse with this male gamete. So likewise, any of the female gamete can fuse with any of the male gamete, as a result of which these 16 different organisms will be formed. This is the genotype, that means which type of genes they have. But if we see phenotypically, jo hame dikhta hai, this first plant, that means wherever the round symbol is there, they will be the round shape of the seeds and yellow color. Why? Because this is round and yellow. Here also it is round and yellow because Y is a dominant allele and the recessive allele will not express itself. It will also be round and yellow, and this will also be round and yellow. Here also this will be round and yellow, same. Yahan round and yellow nahi hoga, yahan round and green, because this is a green color. No dominant allele is there, both the alleles are recessive allele. Okay, so this plant will be have round shape of the seed but yellow color. Again round and yellow, here again it will be round but green color. Similarly round and yellow, here also round and yellow. Yahan pe it will not be round. Why? Because these are the recessive alleles. It will be wrinkled. So it is wrinkled and yellow. Yahan pe bhi it will be wrinkled and yellow. Here it will be round and yellow. Yahan pe it will be round but it will be green in color. Round and green in color. Here it will be wrinkled and yellow. And here it will be wrinkled and green in color. So in all this combination, you will find out of 16, 9 organism, they will show yellow and round, yellow color seed and the shape is round. 3 will show yellow and wrinkled, 3 will show green and round, and 1 will show green and wrinkled. So the ratio comes to 9:3:3:1. Okay, this is a ratio. Actually, when he did the experiment, in total plants, he found, Mendel found that 315 plants, they were having yellow color and the round seeds. 101, they have yellow and the wrinkled seed. 108, they will have round green and the round seeds. And 32, they were having green and the wrinkled seeds. And if you find out the ratio of these, that will come 9:3:3:1. This shows that there are two characters, one is yellow and round. This is not found in the parent plant. Again, green and wrinkled, this is also, none of the parent were having green and wrinkled. That means those characters which were not present in one parent, they were also appear in F2 generation, indicating that there is an independent inheritance of two separate traits. दो सेपरेट ट्रेट अगर हम लेते हैं तो दे बिहेव इंडिपेंडेंटली, इनका जो इनहेरिटेंस है इट इज़ इंडिपेंडेंट, देर इज़ नो लिंकेज. फ्रॉम दिस मेंडल पोस्टुलेटेड द थर्ड लॉ विच इज़ नोन एज अ लॉ ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट असॉटमेंट, विच इंडिकेट्स दैट इफ टू करेक्टर्स आर टेकन टूगेदर द इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ दिस टू करेक्टर्स आर इंडिपेंडेंट, दे आर इंडिपेंडेंटली inherited. So this is a Mendel third law. Now let us talk about how do trait get expressed. जो characters हैं वो express कैसे करते हैं, what is there which expresses this trait, or what is the basis of expression of a trait. Trait means character. Now we know that in the cell the DNA is there, and this DNA, ये जो deoxyribonucleic acid है, it has the information for making a particular protein inside the cell. So the which type of protein will be formed is present on the DNA. Okay, and these proteins, when they are formed, they act as an enzyme. They act an enzyme because all the enzymes, they are proteins. Now enzyme ka function kya hai? The function of the enzyme is it stimulate a particular chemical reaction in the organism. These enzymes are also known as biocatalyst because they act as a catalyst, but enzymes are, they work inside the organism, that is why they are known as a biocatalyst. And these biocatalysts, they stimulate a particular specific reaction. Okay, now the product which is formed because of this reaction, ये प्रोडक्ट क्या बनता है, दैट प्रोडक्ट विल इंडिकेट विच टाइप ऑफ करेक्टर द प्लांट विल शो. दैट मीन्स लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द हाइट ऑफ द प्लांट. ओके, नाउ द प्रोडक्ट विच इज फॉर्म्ड आफ्टर दिस एंजाइम्स दे वर्क ऑन द केमिकल रिएक्शन विल इंडिकेट वेदर द हाइट ऑफ द प्लांट विल बी टॉल और इट विल बी ड्वार्फ. That and we know that the height of the plant tall hai ya dwarf hai, that depends upon the amount of growth hormone. There is a growth hormone. If the growth hormone is produced in large amount, that means the height of the plant will be more, and if the growth hormone jo hai it will be less, then the height of the plant will be dwarf. So the height of the plant depend upon the amount of the growth hormone which is synthesized, and this hormone trigger the growth. Okay, the amount of hormone which is synthesized, ye kon depend kar, on which this is dependent. So whether the hormone, amount of the hormone is more or the amount of hormone is less, depend upon the efficiency of the process of synthesizing a particular enzyme. If the enzyme which is synthesized is more, then the amount of hormone which will be synthesized will be more, as a result the height of the plant will be tall. So if a specific enzyme which work as a protein, because proteins are enzymes, so if a specific enzyme work very efficiently, then more hormone will be present, more growth hormone will be present, and that growth hormone jo hai agar zyada hai to height of the plant will be tall. And if that gene of tallness, ये tallness की जो gene है, that means the protein or the enzyme, अगर उस gene में थोड़ी alteration हो जाती है, उसमें थोड़ा सा फ़र्क आ जाता है, as a result of which that gene, what is a gene? It is a segment of a DNA. If some change occurs, if some alteration occur in the DNA, then the enzyme which is produced or the protein which is produced, if that is in less amount, then less amount of hormone will be present, and as a result the plants will be dwarf. So it is the genes which control the characteristics or which controls the trait. So what controls the traits? The genes controls the traits. And what is the function of the gene? The function of the gene is to synthesize a protein. These protein may act as an enzyme, and if more enzymes are there, more product will be formed, the dominant character will be there. If some alteration occur in the gene, as a result less protein or a different type of protein is formed, which because of that the less efficient enzyme is there, of course the less amount of hormone will be produced, as a result the height of the plant will be dwarf. So I'll finish my lecture here, students. We'll continue with the same chapter in my next lecture. Till then, stay safe.